Once again, college campuses in Delhi have proven to be unsafe for women. Recently, we saw during a college festival in Gargi College, a group of men entered the college and there were women students who were there who claimed that they were molested. Now, we are trying to find out what exactly has been happening. Why are the girls of our universities feeling unsafe within a safe place that we call campus? Why can't we provide them adequate security? We are talking to some special guests over here. We have Arpita from NSUI. We also have Yogita with us. She's a women's activist. And joining us will also be Avantika, who is part of the student's body. And due to reasons which are quite clear to everyone, we will not be disclosing, we will not be showing her face because it's not really safe now, Avantika. I understand that men entered college and it's a huge problem for women colleges especially as far as security is concerned. What exactly happened that day and what is the what have you guys decided now?
Okay, so what happened that day was the second gate that we had was for the entry of men, and this gate was broken open. So a lot of reports say that these gates were broken open, but also we've seen the admin open these gates to the students, and without checking IDs, without checking passes that each girl was given, these men were let to enter college, and they were given permission to come and be part of the fest. And yeah, so then whatever ensued, the harassment, the molestation, everything occurred after that.
So you've been talking to the administration for a very long time.
Yes.
What has the student body decided?
The student body has placed certain demands in front of the administration that we will be releasing very soon. What we have released to the media right now is a statement of the timeline that has occurred, which we will present to you also, which I can read out. So also what has happened is we've given the administration 2 days to make sure that our demands are met. So the timeline I can read out to you.
So these 2 days for them to work it all out and give you some solid concrete results.
So the student body gathered at 10 a.m. near the main arc. The collective complaints and demands were read to all the students at 10:10. By 10:30, the entire mobilization moved to the art squad along with the administration and the principal. And at 10:45, the administration expressed categorical support after listening to the demands and complaints. At 11 a.m., the administration and the principal demanded an hour to formulate a way to meeting our demands. The student body in the meantime was addressed by the DCW, that is the Delhi Commission for Women. The authorities of the Delhi Commission for Women expressed how they'll send an official notice to the administration of Gargi College and to the police present on campus on 6th February. At 12:30, the staff council and administration addressed the students again, wherein the student body was told that a fact-finding committee would be set up, which will comprise of an elected teacher and student from each department, which brings them to about a 34-member team. The committee will work independently of the administration and all other forms of authorities in college. Further questions and grievances were addressed to the entire administration, and the principal was asked for a written apology, a minimum security plan, a press release, and written answers were also demanded. The administration has been granted a 2-day break to get back to the student body with the demands, which also includes the breakdown of the entire budget of revenue with special emphasis to the budget of security.
Right. Okay, that's a long list of demands, and I'm sure that the authorities are working on it. Thank you very much for speaking with us. We do understand you have your constraints, but some more students here are joining me, and again I would request them to keep their back towards the camera. I just want to know the account of what happened that day. What exactly happened?
उस दिन हम आए हुए थे सब, काफ़ी क्राउड था, बहुत ज़्यादा था, और लड़के थे बहुत ज़्यादा, उन्होंने हरेसमेंट किया था लड़कियों के साथ, लड़कियाँ रो भी रही थी काफ़ी, हमने देखा था, और लड़के जिनकी एंट्री हुई थी विदाउट पासिस भी हुई थी, लड़कियों की लड़की बहुत कम थी उस दिन और लड़के बहुत ज़्यादा थे उस टाइम पे.
But how come wasn't there anyone at the gates to stop them from entering? अंदर जाने से रोकने के लिए कोई नहीं था?
काफी लोग थे, but वो है ना लड़के जबरदस्ती इतना ज़्यादा push किया और काफी सारी strength में थे लड़के, काफी सारी strength में थे लड़के, तो उन्होंने इतना मतलब push किया तो वो security कम थी, इतनी नहीं थी हमारी security, bouncers वगैरह भी इतने नहीं थे,
कुछ भी नहीं था, कुछ भी नहीं था,
हमारा staff था जो मेरे teachers का staff था वो थे, वो कहाँ तक इस चीज़ को handle करते, और काफी सारे एकदम से rush आया, जैसे हल्का सा दरवाजा खुला car की entry के लिए तो उसी के साथ ही सारा rush एकदम हो गया और फिर दरवाजे वगैरह भी तोड़ दिए गए, काफी कुछ हुआ.
When this happened, wasn't there anyone to save you guys? कोई पुलिस वाला, कोई स्कूल का, सॉरी कॉलेज का कोई टीचर, कोई मतलब सिक्योरिटी पर्सनल?
There were only 4 persons. अदरवाइज वी डोंट नो कि उन्होंने क्या किया या फिर क्या नहीं. सिर्फ और सिर्फ वो चार ही पुलिस वाले थे एंड दैट टू वी थिंक कि वो सिर्फ स्टार के लिए ही होंगे नॉट फॉर द
सर. स्टार के लिए आए हुए थे, स्टूडेंट्स के लिए कोई भी नहीं था.
मतलब जो परफॉर्मेंस द पर्सन हु केम टू परफॉर्म ओवर हियर यू फील इट वाज फॉर हिज सिक्योरिटी दैट दे वर देयर बट व्हेन यू गाइस वर कंप्लेनिंग अबाउट इट दे डिडंट रिएक्ट. I mean, they were seeing this. Didn't they react? The policemen, the security, the bouncers, they didn't react.
वो मतलब उनको ये था कि सब घुस गए तो हम क्या कर सकते हैं, किस किस को बाहर निकालेंगे. As they don't have passes और सबके जाके individually passes check करना, it's so tough. So crowd was so much कि उसमें girls का ratio काफी कम था as compared to the boys.
Will you call it inaction, हाथ पे हाथ धरे रहने वाला attitude था? आप क्या ये कहेंगे?
Yeah, you can say that.
So मैं आप लोगों से पूछना चाह रही हूँ उस दिन क्या हुआ था और जो हुआ है उसके बाद आप लोगों को किसी तरह का डर तो नहीं है अपने कैंपस में आने में?
स्टार्टिंग में तो दो तीन बार ही गेट क्रैश हो गया था उस दिन और बहुत सारे लोगों को अंदर ऐसे ही वो चले गए थे क्योंकि गेट पे कोई मॉनिटर नहीं कर रहा था और आने दिया था. बहुत सारे लोग ऐसे गेट्स के ऊपर से भी चढ़ के आ गए थे और उसके बाद आज हमने थोड़ा एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन के साथ प्रोटेस्ट वगैरह रखी है तो इट्स स्टिल बेटर दैन इट वॉज द अदर डे. But of course, fear तो रहता है and the general environment of the college is also not that positive.
लेकिन कभी आप लोगों ने सोचा था कि अपने ही कॉलेज में ऐसी स्थिति हो जाएगी कि जब लड़कियों के साथ बदसलूकी हो रही होगी और इतनी गंदी हरकतें होंगी?
सोचा तो था क्योंकि लास्ट ईयर मेरे साथ भी हुआ था. इस साल मैं थर्ड डे पे नहीं आई थी और मैं अपने घर पे थी तब मैंने बहुत सारे टेक्स्ट रिसीव किए थे अपने फ्रेंड्स से कि क्या करें हम क्या करें कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा.
आप क्या इसलिए नहीं आए क्योंकि पिछले साल आपके साथ
नहीं ऐसा? ऐसा कुछ रीज़न नहीं था बट मेरे को बस आना ही नहीं था बट इट वॉज डिसहार्टनिंग टू सी ऑल माई फ्रेंड्स क्राई इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी एंड मतलब मैं अलग अलग लोगों को जाके हग कर रही हूँ कि इट्स ओके वील सॉर्ट दिस आउट कुछ करेंगे इसके बारे में. वीडियोज देख रही हूँ मैं लोग ऊपर से कूद रहे हैं.
हमारा कॉलेज हमारे लिए बहुत ही सेफ स्पेस रहा है हमेशा से बिकॉज बाकी जगहों पे बहुत ही ब्लेटेंट सेक्सिज्म फेस करते हैं हम और एक ही गार्गी कॉलेज हमारे लिए एक सेफ स्पेस होती है जहाँ पे दे गिव अस द राइट टू डू व्हाट एवर वी वांट टू दे अलाउ अस टू बी व्हाट वी आर और हमें कोई सोचना नहीं पड़ता कि हमें यहाँ से यहाँ पर कोई गंदी तरीके से देखेगा या यहाँ पर कोई हमें टोकेगा कि तुम ऐसे क्यों पहन के कपड़े आ रहे हो या वो क्यों कर रहे हो या ये क्यों कर रहे हो. एंड आई थिंक मैं आई एम इन माई सेकेंड ईयर और दो साल में पहली बार मुझे ऐसा फील हुआ है कि ये जगह इज़ नथिंग बट हेल. दैट डे वॉज ट्रॉमेटिक फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस और आई थिंक ऐसा फिर ज़रूरत ही नहीं है हमें अगर हमें हमारे कॉलेज में आके ये बोला जाए कि हमें ज़रूरत नहीं अगर हमें सेफ़ नहीं फील करते हैं अपने कॉलेज में. हमें कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है ऐसे फेस्ट की. हम सोसाइटी के बच्चे हैं हमारा एनुअल इवेंट होता है हर साल होता है हमें वो ज़रूरत होती है उस चीज़ की क्योंकि बाकी कॉलेज से बच्चे आते हैं कम्पीट करने के लिए.
आप अपना इवेंट क्यों छोड़ेंगे? आपका हक है वो. आपके कॉलेज को आपको सिक्योरिटी देनी पड़ेगी
मैम. एग्जैक्टली ना कि उन्हें हमें सिक्योरिटी देनी चाहिए ये उनका वो क्या बोलते हैं ड्यूटी है बट वो अगर हमें नहीं देंगे तो ऑफकोर्स वी हैव टू प्रोटेस्ट कि हमें ये ड्यूटीज़ दो तभी हम आपके लिए कुछ करें. हम सोसाइटी कॉलेज के लिए हैं कॉलेज की है तो हमें भी वही रिस्पेक्ट वापस मिलनी चाहिए. अगर हम इतना कर रहे हैं अपने कॉलेज के लिए इतना अपने लिए अपने एज एन आर्टिस्ट हम इतना दिखा रहे हैं अपने टैलेंट को बाहर जाके अपने कॉलेज को रिप्रेजेंट करते हुए तो क्या हम सिक्योरिटी भी डिमांड नहीं कर सकते अपने अथॉरिटीज से? वहाँ पर भी आके वो हमसे पूछ बोल रहे हैं हमें ब्लेम करा जा रहा है कि हमारी गलती है. हमें पता नहीं किस तरीके की बातें बोली गई है उस दिन फेस्ट के अंदर और उसके बाद भी दे एक्सपेक्ट अस कि हम उसके बाद भी उनके लिए खड़े रहेंगे और कुछ नहीं बोलेंगे. दे वर नॉट एक्सपेक्टिंग अस टू रिवोल्ट लाइक दैट विच इज़ वाई दे वर सो शॉक कि इतने सारे बच्चे सुबह 10 बजे आके कैंपस में खड़े हो गए और बोल रहे हैं कि हम कोई क्लास अटेंड नहीं करेंगे कहीं नहीं जाएंगे जब तक हमें सारे हमारे डिमांड्स नहीं मिल जाते.
मैं बस एक आखिरी सवाल आपसे पूछना चाहती हूँ वो ये कि हम लोग कई बार सोचते हैं कि टीचर अगर फीमेल हो आपके एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफिशियल फीमेल हो तो इस तरह की प्रॉब्लम्स आपको नहीं होंगे लेकिन क्या इनसेंसिटिविटी आप लोगों को जो असंवेदनशीलता है वो आप लोगों को फीमेल ऑफिशियल्स के साथ भी जूझनी पड़ती?
मैम इट्स शॉकिंग कि फीमेल स्टाफ के साथ भी ये होता है. आई वो इनफैक्ट आई थिंक पेट्रियार्की एक ऐसी चीज़ है जो इतना डीपली जा चुका है कि वुमेन फेल टू रियलाइज कि इट्स हैपनिंग टू देम ऑल्सो एंड देर टेकिंग पार्ट इन इट देर एनकरेजिंग इट. कुछ फीमेल स्टाफ ऐसी है जिनको आइडिया ही नहीं है कि वो क्या बोल रही हैं और वो कितना गलत है. वो सिंपली जनरेशन गैप का वो बोल के बोल देती हैं कि हमारे टाइम में ऐसे होता था. नहीं चाहे वो किसी भी टाइम में हो वो गलत है,
वो सही नहीं है।
तुम
जनरेशन गैप जस्टिफाई नहीं करता मोलेस्टेशन को।
बिल्कुल मैं आपको पर्सनली भी बोलना चाहूँगी, जो आप लोगों के साथ हुआ इट्स अपसेटिंग, हम सब के लिए बहुत अपसेटिंग है। एनीवे थैंक यू सो मच आप लोगों ने हमारे साथ बात की। यू हर्ड वॉट दीज गर्ल्स आर सेइंग, आई मीन इट्स क्वाइट शॉकिंग। ऑल ऑफ अस हैव स्टडीड इन कॉलेजेस इन दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी, यू बोथ आर फ्रॉम विमेंस कॉलेजेस एंड दे आर ऑलवेज वल्नरेबल पॉइंट्स, सो इन अ ओकेजन लाइक दिस शुड देयर हैव बीन मोर सिक्योरिटी?
Absolutely, and I'm shocked that the students themselves are saying that there was no action on behalf of the administration at the moment. I mean, after the harm was done, everybody is trying to do something, but there could have been things that could have been done to prevent it from happening in the first place. Why were so many men allowed to enter the college campus when there is a limited pass system and security system where IDs need to be checked? Firstly, it could have been prevented. Secondly, at the moment it happened, actions could have been taken. I mean, these girls, they've said themselves that nothing. Oh, there were only four people and they didn't know who to go to. There was nobody trying to help them. And there was an attitude ke chalo ho gaya to ab hum kya kare. So I think that is the main problem. I mean, right now, of course, lodging an FIR or taking action and all these media attention and mobilization is important. But when something could have been done at that current time, why wasn't it done in the first place?
Yeah, and I must tell you that the police has appointed a committee and there are senior police officers, female lady police officers who are handling the investigation. But the question, Yogita, also remains. This is not new. As you were just telling me, you're from Miranda House. We have seen instances of men coming and masturbating outside hostels. So this is not new what has happened. Shouldn't we be ready for this and should we be prepared?
Even more so, that what we are discussing in many, many years ago. I mean, knowing Delhi is unsafe, after Nirbhaya 2012, a lot of awakening happened. And after even after so many of so-called reforms, if this is a state, I mean, what are we talking? Delhi is any which way is unsafe. I mean, we are discussing it every single day on channels about the rapes and the sexual violence, which is increasing like an epidemic, especially in Delhi. And what are we expecting? We just voted for a new government, which will be declared tomorrow. I mean, this should be the first priority. If our daughters, our sisters are not safe within the four walls, I mean, how can you say that you are going to save this girl on the road? Last mile connectivity is far off, but how about a crowded place? We are not even safe inside of college campus. Institutions are unsafe. I mean, this is another awakening. Our government should take it more seriously, and it is not new. They should have been, as she said, that they should have been.
But I do have a question to ask, and that is that, you know, these fests happen every year. These colleges have been here since 80s and 70s. So how come suddenly we saw this instance? We have earlier seen boys going inside and maybe a few instances, you know. No, but something like this is men, middle-aged men going inside and molesting kids. You know These why? Are children for them.
Why? Because we have not seen a mandate, you know, a mandate hanging off people like who raped Nirbhaya and brutally killed her. So, you know, end of the day, it gives motivation to these budding criminals, budding rapists, that yes, in this country, you can get away with anything. If these people are not hanged, I mean, they knew that. They got motivation from somewhere. It cannot happen overnight that they thought, okay, let's go to Gargi College and do something like shitty, you know. It definitely was
You feel it was a motivated mob?
Absolutely motivated mob, and they knew nobody will do anything to them. If helpless students are not being heard by the administration themselves, you can imagine, because this is the country where these onus is always on the students and the girls to prove ki aapke saath ye hua tha.
Arpita, you are a student. I'd like to know, usually the Delhi police, you know, stations some security personnel around the campus. Do they provide adequate security? Because in the evenings you would be walking around. Do you feel safe in the campus usually?
Of course not. We don't feel safe, because if that was the case, if we had enough adequate security and protection, this thing wouldn't have happened in Gargi at the first place. I mean, it happened because there was not adequate security available. And at the end, I have an observation as a college student. I come from a girls' college and I feel like it's a safe campus. It's a safe space for me inside my college. But you know, I have this observation that I don't want to divert the attention, but that campus hooliganism has been normalized to such a large extent कि ऐसे लोगों का आना, फॉर पीपल टू कम बार्ज इन, ब्रेक द गेट्स एंड यू नो ग्रोप वीमेन एंड मोलेस्ट वीमेन एंड जस्ट कॉज वैंडलिज्म एंड हुलिगनिज्म इन जनरल हैज बिकम सो नॉर्मल, हैज बीन नॉर्मलाइज टू सच एन एक्सटेंट दैट nobody thinks twice before doing something like this.
Also, I want to ask you about the kind of comments the students heard when they complained about it. Agar aapko itna hi chinta tha, aaye kyun? If you were so worried about your security, why did you come for a... This happens every time. You always overstate cases of molestation. Everything becomes molestation with you. The insensitivity of college authorities. Do you, as a woman student, do you face it again and again?
Of course.
I mean, and these are teachers and administration officials who are women.
Yes, that is how every time it comes about mindset, right? So even today, there has been no change in the mindsets of people. We have professors, educated professors and teachers and principals and college administration people not really doing anything about it. Instead, passing remarks, why did you come in the first place? You should have known that it's unsafe. I mean, it's bizarre for someone
rather
educated. Yeah, for someone who talks about feminism and who teaches us feminism in our syllabus cannot take a stand for us.
Absolutely, and it's very unfortunate that these girls have to prove that something like this happened to them. Even the law protects them that yes, whatever they said has to be taken as, you know, as a statement and has to be acted upon, you know, and these comments even dishearten them also, and it is very demotivating. You really saw nobody wants to talk about it, and they are really threatened and demotivated, and there might be some action against them, you know. So I mean, this is a very unfortunate part. The problem is that we victimization of the victim happens in this country.
Absolutely. I mean, it is shocking. Right now, I must tell you that the girls are avoiding to talk to the media or anybody as such, because of course it has been a painful incident. It's painful to recount it, and moreover they are also worried about how the authorities are going to react if they speak to the media. There are students here who are coming in solidarity from other colleges here. Aap apna naam bataiye aur ye bataiye, why have you come here?
I'm Vinila Krishnan from Gargi College. I'm from Pol Science Department. I came here to give solidarity in this issue, and I, representing the NSUI, we condemn the issue, and this is very unfortunate and shouldn't have happened in this college, or any other university like Delhi University. And I don't know how they have allotted the outsiders to come inside. I don't know the administration how they allotted, because we know that they have been a fest happening here on February 6th, and in every colleges there's a strict, you know, measures from, you know, to allow the outsiders. Identity card also has been there, so this has happened. And the thing is,
you know, I want to ask you, because you are a student of another college, security ki jab hum baat karte hain, aapko lagta hai ki jo girls colleges hote hain, agar usko compare kiya jaye co-ed colleges se, kya yahan par ladkiyan zyada vulnerable hoti hain?
Actually, the thing is, Gargi College is basically a girls college. The parents have been sending the students only because of they think that girls college is little more safe than compared to co-ed colleges. But still, this is happening here. Even I am studying in a girls college, but I think it is little more safe over there, and everybody is coming to college with ID proof. Mm. We are only allowing. But the thing is, your draconian administration is, I think it is, you know, big failure over this issue, and still a big failure over this issue, because safety measures, they didn't provide any of the safety measures while allotting boys or whoever. So, and the thing is, Delhi police have filed, just right now they filed an FIR. This has happened on February 6th. So the CM as well as the other members is not into this issue, and still
I must tell you that though the CM has tweeted and he is raising this issue, but the fact is there is nothing that he can do about it. So the whole problem that happens, the police is not under him. He cannot do anything as far as Delhi University is concerned.
But we are only because the CM is, we can only seek to CM. That's the thing.
Even controlling it.
Exactly.
Somebody has to. There's a governing body, right? So, and sexual harassment at workplace also falls under this particular scenario as well. even I work on that particular aspect also. If you go to colleges, institutions, there's a lot of exploitation. You don't have the committees. Somebody is governing them, UCG or whatever, I don't know. They have to look into it and make some provisions about, especially as you were also mentioning, they are more vulnerable. People, the boys, you know, they think, oh, only girls' college, they would like to barge in and gate crash because they think they're, you know, and especially the hostel, because she studied in hostel, she would understand, I think you also, that it is very, very unsafe place. And who else? I mean, we understand police is not under CM, but then somebody has to take responsibility. Absolutely. We can't go on and on for years, you know.
We,
like,
we have police stations meant for women. We have special police forces. Why can't we? Yeah, exactly. Why can't the police forces provide something extra for colleges that are women colleges? Have you ever seen extra police presence around your college at any time?
Generally, I have never seen any extra police protection being given. Only when things go really out of hand and it's really bad. Yeah, now you see. I mean, there's nothing being done to actually stop something like that, prevent something like that from happening, you know. And no matter how much progress happens in terms of science, in terms of whatever, somewhere or the other, there's always an issue regarding women. Sometimes it's extremely nasty. Sometimes it's something like this happening in an educational institution. Something or the other just keeps on coming. Because last time we had the Unnao rape case. Now we have this issue, molestation and such institutional things happening.
Since you bring up the issue of mindset, I do want to tell here that it was not just molestation. Yeah. It's mental harassment also.
Absolutely.
There were men who threw money on young girls. The implications of something like this, what you're trying to imply, we all understand. And a woman, when she's standing with her friends and somebody throws money at her, this is not just physical, this is mental.
In Delhi, you are judged by the college you study in. Oh, you're from Miranda or you're from Gargi.
And this is one of the top colleges.
Jesus and Mary, all girls college. Oh, girls are easily, you know, walking around with you. You just give money. This is dangerous. I mean, look at the mindset. I mean, I don't have words. You know, it is very disheartening. Being women, we can relate to these things. If somebody throws that money at you, even worse than groping, you know, this girl will be in trauma forever, you know, thinking what is happening. I think they should be even booked for more severe offenses than only groping, because this particular, I don't know, our law as of now, sexual harassment covers everything, but this particular thing of throwing money should be taken very, very seriously, and these goons, they should find them out or whatever it is. They should do it ASAP and reinstill the confidence into these students. Otherwise,
identification of the culprits is not an easy task. The police says they're looking at the CCTV footage, but identifying them, it's not an easy task because they are also not students. But before we go, I just want to point out there are some police officers sitting right there. We can see them comfortably sitting at a bus stop while they're stationed here. And this is the police presence here. So you can imagine what, after the incidents, if this is the situation, what kind of a situation it must have been the time when the incident happened. If we don't take care of our children, our students, if we let these safe places, safe havens, become places where they can easily get assaulted and molested, then we have no answer, we have no face to show to our students. There is no future that we can hope for which will be bright, and we keep expecting from our children that, oh, you are the ones who will bring in the bright future. Give them a bright present first. That's all we have for you. Have a good day.